History never starts or stops, but every era has a distinct starting point. Welcome to mine.
On December 1st, 2010, 120 guests of the world-famous Tony Williams gathered in a privately owned theater in Dallas, Texas. The occasion was an intimate presentation of the soon-to-be-released album, King or the Fool. The centerpiece of the evening was a live painting rendered spontaneously by renowned native Cuban-American artist Rolando Diaz. The work on canvas was inspired by the songs of King or the Fool and ultimately would serve as the album's cover art. The event also was to encourage support for the grassroots effort of the nonprofit Traffic 911, a team of passionate people driven to stop the sale of American children into sexual slavery. The painting was auctioned off to a generous bidder, with 100% of the proceeds donated to Traffic 911. With your support, we can help Traffic 911 build a safe house for girls as young as 10, crying out to be rescued from sexual slavery.
Help young girls that are being trafficked into sex slavery. Yeah. So a lot of you may not know, but it's happening right in your backyard. Sex trafficking is very lucrative. They say that it will top drug trafficking for the number one spot. Wow. Annually, it makes about $32 billion a year, which is more than Starbucks, Google, and Nike combined. You can only sell a drug once, but you can sell a person over and over and over.
So how many of y'all have ever ridden in a taxi cab? Have you ever ridden in a taxi cab? How many of you have ever wondered when you're riding in that taxi cab, I wonder how many children have been raped in the back seat of this cab? That's what's about to descend on us when the Super Bowl comes to town, according to our Attorney General Greg Abbott and the FBI. The pimps pay the taxi cab drivers to turn their cabs into mobile brothels.
So Traffic 911, Team Traffic 911, we are all working together to keep that from happening here. And what Jahira is talking about here is not people being brought into our country in traffic, but this is our own American children being bought and sold for the profit and pleasure of their perpetrators. We are talking 100 to 300,000 U.S. kids every year forced into this.
Thank you.
Additionally, we're offering a limited edition of 300 signed and numbered chiclete prints for $500. A portion of the proceeds from the prints will be donated to Traffic 911 as well. Prints will be available to collectors in the order their payments are received. With your support, we can help Traffic 911 into the doors on one of the most state-of-the-art safe houses in our nation, open for girls as young as 10, crying out to be rescued from prostitution. Please visit theworldfamoustonywilliams.com and click on store for additional purchasing information.
Human trafficking is modern-day slavery. We thought slavery ceased with the Emancipation Proclamation. How fooled we were. Today there are more slaves than at any point in history, twice as many as during the entire transatlantic slave trade. Mainstream culture, so heavily influenced by hip-hop music, has helped the slave trade to thrive. An industry that justifies destroying our nation's richest resource, our youth. Our children are being kidnapped, raped, maimed, brutalized, and killed to serve the demands of their pimps and perpetrators. And our music, with its blatant glamorization of pimping, prostitution, and pornography, has brainwashed us into believing that this is normal and acceptable. So how many songs in your iTunes contain references that glorify pimping, sending messages to our youth that pimping is the legitimate representation of masculinity? Pimping ain't easy. Try being forced into sexual slavery. No girl truly desires to be a prostitute, a whore, a sex slave. No boy should be destined to be a pimp or a human trafficker. In order to change the industry, we must change the demand placed on the product, raising young men in circles of accountability to be respectful and protective of their sisters, their girlfriends, their cousins, their aunts, their nieces, their mothers, their grandmothers, their friends, all women. Is one of the most important efforts a king can do to stop human sex trafficking. It would be foolish for men to do nothing and to think that the crime is not taking place right in the comfort of their own castle. Some say that it takes a village to raise a child. I say it takes a king and all the king's men to save our children.